Okay. I'm Professor Kuisa. We are at the Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. You can see this is an exhibition. This is an innovation week. And in this stand, I have students who have come up with this gadget. I want them to introduce themselves, tell us what they are, what are they doing in this university, which courses, which year, and importantly, why they came up with this gadget and what are their future plans on the same. May I start here?
Okay, my name is Alex Kimeo. I'm doing procurement and contract management at the School of Entrepreneurship and Logistics. I'm currently at my fourth year. It's my colleague Hassan.
Well, my name is Indai Hassan. I'm mostly an innovator and entrepreneur with a background of mechanical engineering. So currently I am the CEO of Hybra Holdings, which is the parent company that manufactures these tools.
My name is David Zilu. I'm a student in JCOAT pursuing bachelor in quantity surveying, a fourth year student.
Tell me, is procurement, you are in innovation and technology, and how did you come up? Normally we have students in the same group class, but you, it's like a heterogeneous group. How did you come together?
So basically, we started all this back in high school, Science Congress actually. Back in high school, they call it Science Congress. So we were
Which school was that?
Machakos
school.
Yeah.
So the three of you were in the same school?
Yeah, we were in the same school, same class, uh-huh. Back in high school. So we actually the first prototype, we actually call it this the fifth prototype that we should actually be calling it the sixth prototype. The first prototype was back in Science Congress. We actually managed to get to the national level with that project. So after high school, we actually sat down and decided to pursue this as a business idea. Yeah. So currently we are in prototype 5. This is the prototype we have brought to present at the JCOAT Texas Tech Expo 9.
So what would you say was the need? You studied high school, you just wanted to satisfy the educational needs, or what was really, what drove you into coming with this particular?
Okay, currently when you look at the manufacturing space in Kenya and Africa at large, it's very limited. Most of the products that we use have either been manufactured in Europe or Asia or China. You walk into a supermarket and 90% of the inventory will either be coming from China or European countries. So we are trying to change that pattern. Can we as Kenyans, can we as young innovators come up with ideas and be brave enough, be confident enough to push them towards production? And using the local materials that we have, using the resources that we be able to get locally, can we be able to scale up a product right from research and development all the way to production and into the market?
Another thing, coming up with this project, we had the idea that in an economy that we live in today, it is characterized with high levels of unemployment, but we still can believe that young ideas can be propagated to the next level through partnerships, and we still believe these forums can provide for us.
Now, I can see quite a number of components on this. Can we see these components and maybe they will explain each and every component?
The main component of the high stove is the steam oven. And when you look at all the retail brands that are selling locally, none has a steam oven. In fact, the steam ovens are very rare. Even when you go to European markets, steam ovens retail at about 200,000 to 800,000 apiece. So we are using the same technology. We are automating all our oven operations and bringing this product to a price point that is going to be achievable, affordable to the Kenyan market.
Going into the market, we're also looking at economies of scale and in ways in which we can reduce on the size and the efficiency at which this stove is working. So going into the market, we'll also look at the pricing of the product and also the other details.
How about other components? I can see like this is a component. Can you explain each other? Like now when you close this, we have all these things. What are they doing? What are their functions on this?
The main strong point is about health benefits, and that one we achieve through the steam oven. However, coming to number two is about versatility. Can we have all of it into one? For example, here we have our gas burners. Here we have an electric grill. Here we have a food warmer. Here we have a place where you can cook your chapatis using charcoal. Down here we have a charcoal grill, and it also serves a double function that you can also warm the water in the oven compartment using the same charcoal that is here. Down here we have this a storage compartment. This is our gas compartment, and it's also the gas compartment also has a fan that runs auto, so that the temperatures here can be kept as at room temperature as low as possible.
This prototype is currently under development. Currently, we're focusing on automation of it in such a way that you can set the temperatures at which you need the food to cook. For example, meat will take a considerably longer time to steam compared to vegetable, right? So, for example, you can set the temperature different depending on the kind of food you use in the steam.
Yeah. I see. Now, you said you studied this thing in high school.
Sure, started there.
Pardon?
The journey started way back.
Oh, the journey started way back. So, if you can recall, what compartment or what was the major in high school and what have you added on? Because innovation means incremental every time you enter. What was it like at high school? And what the major difference that you have, you say value that you have added on it after high school? That means like you come to university and you get more knowledge. At high school, you had less knowledge.
Okay.
Yes.
Back in high school, our hydro stove, as we used to call it back then, was an innovative product that used charcoal and it superheated the water that was in the outside compartment to produce water gas. However, after high school, as we studied water gas, back then it was a hit. Yeah, water gas was a big hit. However, after high school, as we studied water gas and the usability of water gas and how it relates to the household consumption, we realized that it's still a little rudimentary to use in household consumption. And therefore, we shifted into steam ovens, which we considered a much healthier way of preparing our meats.
Okay. So have you put any one of them on the market or on prototype or what stage are you, what are we seeing?
We are still in our R&D stage. This is actually prototype 5, and for the past year and a half we have just been developing prototypes, testing them, iterating on the designs, going to the to seek criticisms and iterating still on the designs. So this is a design that we believe it's actually on the right trajectory towards entering the market.
What challenges would you say you have gone through to reach this stage?
Well, number one, the Kenyan ecosystem innovation really doesn't receive the credit that it deserves. We used to do research at a government research facility. I will not disclose the name. However, we came across a lot of bureaucracies which were actually hindering our path towards innovation. This is a hookah that we have done in Juakali. In Juakali, we have used about 50,000 to fabricate this entire hookah. And we've used about 3 weeks to fabricate the entire hookah. If we were doing it in a government research facility, this entire fabrication could have taken no less than 3 months. It could have costed no less than 300,000 to just make this one. Now, for young innovators like us, raising all that amount of money just to innovate on a cooker. And remember, we are still in R&D phase. We are still bootstrapping. Nobody's actually funding our research. So I would say that the main challenge that we're actually facing is that there's a lot of inertia towards accepting innovation.
Now, people will be watching you on this YouTube. The people might want to reach you now that they have had your challenges. How can someone reach you? Perhaps you will tell us, each one of you, your name, your address, your contact, so that anybody who is watching and want to reach you can do that.
Okay.
As I said, my name is Alex Kimeo. You can catch me in Facebook, Twitter, all other social platforms. Alex Kimeo is my name.
Number, your number?
My number is 0742-283711. 0742-283711. Thank you.
And you can get me in all social media accounts, David Zilu, at David Zilu, and my number is 0704-242441.
My name is Ibrahim Atingo. You can catch me on social media, Facebook Ibra Atingo, Twitter at Ibra Atingo. I'm also the CEO and founder of Hybra, which is the parent company that is doing all these innovations. We can reach us through our website, hybra.com.
Good.